is just a receiver where you can see that data. So you can see why our families tend to use Dexcom and Share instead of that, using the integrated feature. But the newest pump on the market by Medtronic is the first hybrid closed loop pump, which is very exciting. And believe me, there are many more in process, and there's going to be some that are way, way better. This is just step number one towards a better way of treating diabetes. So what happens is that their sensor sends the data to the pump, and then the pump adjusts the basal based on the sensor data. So what that can do is it can smooth out the edges and narrow the gap more than finger stick alone, or just bolusing and basal alone. So that's kind of the most exciting. And there are some pumps that are being worked on now that are dual wave, or not dual wave, but have dual chambers that will have glucagon and insulin, so that when the blood sugar is dropping rapidly, a little tiny squirt of glucagon can stop that. Because think in a pump, insulin action, even at small doses, is about a three-hour, it's a peak with a three-hour window. So when we're dripping in basal at, say, 0.5 an hour, you just have these little mini peaks. Well, let's say you reduce the basal or stop the basal. When is the biggest effect you're going to see on that? It starts a half hour, hour later. So it's not effective in treating lows necessarily. You know, it's going to be very exciting what's coming down the pipe, and certainly they're looking at things like the clinical as well. So I'd like to see if anybody has any questions. Yes?
I work in the ICU, and we get a lot of the DKAs, and once they're feeling better, they say they're very hungry, and they order a lot of food, and we'll cover their sugar, and then cover their carbs. Mm-hmm. But then their stomach hurts, and they can only eat third, or maybe 25%. And a lot of residents say, well, endocrinologists don't want us to wait to see what they eat, just cover it before. What do you think?
Well, that's an ongoing battle. It probably depends on the endocrinologist. We have one who very definitely wants it prior. But in my opinion, under those circumstances, it's preferable to dose it after based on what you eat, because otherwise you overdose. So then in the ICU setting, you have an IV where you can give dextrose to replace or manage the blood sugar. But it's in my opinion, it's preferable to do it after the fact. And the same is true in small kids who are very finicky eaters and don't know how much they're going to eat. We recommend dose it as soon as you know. As soon as you know that they're going to be able to eat. Pumps, it's much easier on the outside because you can give some now, you can give some later without doing multiple injections. But yeah, that's my opinion.
Are there like other technologies like apps or something for to help these kids with their carb counting and stuff?
Yeah, there's lots of different apps on the market. For carb counting specifically, Lenny the Lion is one. It's kind of a fun game. There's another app that we've recommended, Figwee. It's F-I-G-W-E-E. And what, and, you know, I question some of the accuracy on Figwee. And as a dietitian, you know, portioning and that kind of thing. But it's got pictures of food where you can change how much it fills the plate. But we have a number, like some of our young adults especially really love that application. Yeah, and certainly things like Google are really great for looking at things. We still teach carbless because there's basic foods without labels that you can, once you learn the portion, you can, once you learn it, you have it memorized, and things that you eat regularly, so it's very easy to say, okay, I know that a cup of pasta is 45 grams, or small apple is 15, that kind of thing, a slice of bread is 15. So that's just another tool as well. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Lots of phone apps.